Bro, you never know. Some of these people should just have fucking psycho emblazoned across their heads so you know what you're dealing with.
That bad, eh?
And when we're driving back from my brother's place, and she just starts fucking punching me in the face, you know, and she's screaming, "You don't love me, you don't love me."
No way, mate.
And I mean, I'm going 100 km on the motorway, so I grab her arm. I'm like, "Stop fucking hitting me."
What'd she do?
You're small, you're large. Well, she starts crying. She's like, "Oh, you broke my arm, you broke my arm." Yeah, I know, it was bullshit. I was just holding it, you know. But she's like, "Oh, you know, when I was a kid, my mother stomped on it. It's really bad. Someone breathes on it, it falls apart." It was bullshit, but entertaining. I just thought, well, if I can get you to the hospital and get a couple of minutes peace and quiet, I'll be happy, you know. But we get to the hospital, she won't get out of the fucking car.
No.
Right, she wants to go to a special hand doctor.
Raise 100.
That's a man who's bluffing.
So full of shit.
Right, so we go to a hand doctor the next day and he's doing x-rays and he's looking it up and down and stuff, and surprise, surprise, he can't find anything wrong with it. You know, and I'm not going to disagree with him. So anyway, he puts it in a splint and he wraps it up a little bit just to make her feel better, sends us on our way. We're driving home again. She starts fucking punching me in the head again.
With the broken hand?
Yeah.
Raise 200.
What the fuck are you doing, man? You in?
Yeah.
By this stage, you know, I've had enough. We drive around the corner, I pull the car over, jump out of the car, take the keys out of the ignition because I know she's going to do something stupid. Go around the other side of the car, open the door up, she won't get out. I have to pick her up, put her on the side of the fucking road, you know, and she's laughing, like Tickle Me Elmo or some shit, which terrifies me. I go around the other side of the car, jump in, I take off. After about 50 or 60 metres, I realise I'm being watched. I look out the left-hand window. She's holding onto the fucking wing mirror, you know, like that gremlin out of Twilight Zone.
What?
I was terrified. I slam on the brake. She starts rolling down the road. And just at this moment, what happens? This fucking cop car comes around the corner.
Hey, bro.
And of course, he pulls up right next to us, you know, and I'm just thinking, oh, shit.
Who's this?
Oh, just this cop.
What?
Bro, get the fuck out of my kitchen.
Can I have this beer?
No, you can't have that beer. So yeah, within 5 minutes, we've got another cop car, we've got an ambulance, we've got a fucking fire engine, you know? Just 17 guys in uniform standing around thinking I'm this piece of shit that beats up his girlfriend and fucking runs her over.
I'm all in.
Who's this girl?
Oh, just this girl I used to see.
Melissa?
Not Melissa, cop.
Oh, which girl?
Fuck, dude, I'm trying to tell a story here.
You in?
Yeah, I'm in, man.
I'm all in too.
Big hand, boys.
Just turn him over.
Bro, you gonna go in on a pair of threes?
Why would you go all in on that?
You never know what that last card's gonna be.
Hey, Nick.
I love playing cards with you, man. The dumbest dude I ever met.
Hey, Nick.
What?
Do you have any pills?
Are you fucking joking, man?
Oh,
Jesus. Right, you guys ready? Here we go. You're the luckiest motherfucker I ever met.
I prefer to think of it as something bigger than that.
I'm buying back in.
Nick.
Yeah, I'm in as well.
Nick.
What, man?
Do you have any?
For fuck's sake, man. Why are you always round here in my pocket for pills? Look at you. I mean, you're standing in the kitchen I told you to get the fuck out of, drinking the beer I told you to put back in the fridge. Let's hear a please for a change.
Can I please have a pill?
What the fuck are you laughing at?
What?
You want a pill too, I take it?
Yeah.
Well, can I get a please?
Can I please have a pill?
Nah. Let's have you next to your boyfriend, come on.
Oh,
come on. Two look so cute together, I will say that. Now on your knees.
Bro.
Come on.
You want a pill or not? Now say after me, dearest Lord Nicholas.
Dearest Lord Nicholas.
Whose power and might knows no bounds.
Come on.
Come on, man, you want a pill?
Whose power and might knows no bounds.
Please, oh please, show us a good time tonight.
Please,
please,
oh please,
oh please,
give
show
us
a good
time,
tonight.
Yeah,
no. What? Bro, come on.
You're all right, all right. I've got a proposition for you, gentlemen. You see these two pills?
Yeah.
Well, one of them is the last of the batch of the best pills that I ever had in my life. But the other one will have you shitting for 3 days at least.
What is this, bro?
This is the game, man. One of you is going to have the time of your life tonight, and the other one's going to have the worst time of his life.
Can't we just have two good pills?
Yeah.
Well, man, I mean, you're my brother, you know? I love you. But I really want to see you suffer tonight. Come on, it's decision time, boys.
Fuck.
Come on. Time's ticking. 3, 2, 1.
Fuck it!
Sleeping pills?
Yeah, bro.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Stink, bro.
That's life. That's life. That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June, I said
that's life,
and as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stopping on a